Let's solve this equation. Observations show that only some school students are currently able to solve it. However, the method used to solve it might come in handy for college and university admission tests. Where to start? On the left side of the equation, we see a sum of squares. Let's try to complete the square on the left side. To do this, let's recall the formula of the square of a difference. Thus, to complete the square of the difference, we need to subtract twice the product of x and x divided by x plus 1. Let's subtract twice the product of x and x divided by x plus 1 from the left side and add it back to keep the equation. Now the first three terms form the square of the difference of x and x divided by x plus 1. Let's rewrite the equation taking this into account. Now let's simplify the expression inside the brackets. Let's bring the difference of x and x divided by x plus 1 to a common denominator. The common denominator is x plus 1. In the numerator we get x squared plus x and minus x. And we rewrite the rest. We cancel out x minus x in the numerator of the first fraction. And finally get x squared divided by x plus 1, all of this squared, plus 2 multiplied by x squared divided by x plus 1. And all of this is equal to 40 divided by 9. Now, if we look closely at the equation, we can see that it's convenient to replace x squared divided by x plus 1 with a new variable, for example, with the variable y. As a result, we get the quadratic equation y squared plus 2y equals 40 divided by 9. Let's multiply both sides of the equation by 9. Then, let's subtract 40 from both sides of the equation. We get 9y squared plus 18y minus 40 equals 0. This is a standard quadratic equation which can be solved using the discriminant formula. Let's recall the formula for the roots of a quadratic equation through the discriminant. Let's apply it to our equation. Thus, we get two roots. Y is either negative 10/3 or 4/3. Returning to the original variable, we substitute the value of y and get two equations. The first equation, x squared divided by x plus 1, equals negative 10/3. Multiplying the elements of the equation according to the property of proportion and rearranging gives us a quadratic equation. Let's calculate the discriminant of this equation. It's negative. Therefore, the first quadratic equation has no roots on the set of real numbers. Let's consider the second equation. X squared divided by x plus 1 is 4/3. We multiply the elements of the equation according to the property of proportion. Then we transfer everything to the left side. Let's again apply the formula for calculating the roots of a quadratic equation through the discriminant. The original equation has two roots, either x equals 2 or x equals negative 2/3. Please like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to the channel. It's very important for me to be able to continue my work. Bye!